some improvements in the Rankine cycle. Because the actual Rankine cycle has a lot of improvements like reheat and regeneration. So in this talk we will discuss about the reheat Rankine cycle. In the Rankine cycle, the condition of steam at the end of expansion in the turbine is very wet. This wet steam results in the corrosion of turbine blades, leading to losses in the cycle efficiency. Hence it has become necessary to reheat the steam after part of the expansion in the turbine was over, so that the resulting condition of steam after the complete expansion fell within the region of permissible wetness. So we expect almost 0.9% dry steam basically. So we will see the reheating process along with the TS diagram. Superheated steam coming out of the boiler enters the high pressure turbine in condition 1 and is expanded in the turbine to an intermediate condition, pressure condition 2, as shown in the figure. The steam at the condition 2 is taken out from the high pressure turbine and reheated in the boiler to the original temperature T1 at a constant pressure. The superheated steam at condition 3 leaves the boiler and enters the low pressure turbine where it is expanded to the condenser pressure condition 4. Note that the dryness fraction of steam entering the condenser with the reheat cycle is greater than that without the reheat, that is condition 8. The condensate is pumped to the boiler and then brought to the high pressure turbine to repeat the process. Now we can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is without reheat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, there is no low pressure turbine here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is with reheat. Without reheat, 1, 8, 1, straight away it comes to 8, 5, 6, 7. See here, 1, 8, 5, 6, 7. This is without reheat. But with reheat, from 2 to 3 again it is going. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. So this is the TS diagram for without reheat, and this is the reheat. So far we have seen only one superheating, but here now again it is heated. So now we can see that condition 4 is more drier than the condition 8. This is x is equal to 1, this is saturated vapor line, this is x is equal to 0, this is saturated liquid line. So the more we go towards the right side, that is S here, the condensate, the steam leaving the turbine is more dry. The idea is reheat Rankine cycle to improve the dryness fraction of the steam at the low pressure turbine outlet. So here the turbine outlet, it is more dry when compared to 8 without reheat. So now as per the usual notation, work done divided by heat supplied is the thermal efficiency. Here the work done is turbine work plus pump divided by heat supplied. This turbine work is high pressure turbine plus low pressure turbine plus the pump divided by boiler plus reheater. Now we are adding more heat, so that is reheating process. So that is, if you put H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4 plus H6 minus H5 divided by boiler is H1 minus H6 and reheater is H3 minus H2. In actual practice, reheating increases the output of the turbine and hence overall efficiency of the plant. However, reheating requires more maintenance and hence additional expenditure. But reheating is done, and you can see in the earlier discussions what we had only one turbine, but now we have got two turbines. So first is a high pressure turbine and the second is a low pressure turbine. So from high pressure turbine, the steam is exhausted and goes to the boiler, heated, and again comes to the low pressure turbine. So this is what is seen from 1, 2, 3, and the outlet from the low pressure turbine, that is at 4, is more drier than outlet from the high pressure turbine, which would have been at 8. So this is the idea to improve the thermal efficiency of the Rankine cycle. There is something called reheat cycle. So you need to understand this diagram. The boiler is common. First it goes to high pressure turbine, exhausted, goes to the low pressure turbine, then comes to the condenser, condensed, pumped back to the boiler. So this is a reheat cycle for improving the efficiency of a